Apple has entered the AI game, and already most of its fans are backing out. A new study shows 73% of iPhone users don't see value in Apple's AI features. That's not just a product problem, it's a future problem. Because if Apple can't get people to care about the next evolution of technology, is it even Apple anymore? Let's go back for a second, back to 2007. Steve Jobs walks on stage, pulls a sleek black rectangle out of his pocket and says, "Today, Apple is going to reinvent the phone." And just like that, the world changed. The iPhone wasn't just a phone, it was a pocket-sized revolution. Multi-touch, the App Store, visual voicemail. Features we take for granted now, but back then, they were mind-blowing. And that's what made Apple special. It wasn't just about the hardware, it was about the feeling. The feeling that this company saw the future before we did, and was kind enough to hand it to us in a clean white box. They made tech feel human, personal, magical. But here we are, more than 15 years later, and something feels off. Today, we're watching Google roll out AI that can write entire essays and hold conversations like it's a sci-fi movie. Microsoft is reshaping productivity with tools that understand what you mean, not just what you type. OpenAI is literally making digital minds that can see, talk, even reason. And then there's Apple, still tweaking iOS, still demoing features like it's 2015. And Siri, well, let's just say if you've ever asked Siri anything more complex than set a timer, you probably ended up yelling at your phone. So now people are asking the question that used to feel unthinkable, is Apple falling behind? Now, while Apple's been cautiously whispering about AI, the rest of the tech world has been sprinting into the future. Just look around. OpenAI dropped ChatGPT, and within a few weeks, it became the fastest growing app of all time. People are using it to write emails, code websites, plan trips, even draft their wedding vows. I mean, it's everywhere. Over at Microsoft, they didn't just make a chatbot, they put AI into the heart of everything. Word, Excel, PowerPoint, they're all getting smarter. Your documents now help write themselves. Your spreadsheets suggest trends before you even know what to look for. And then there's Google. Their Gemini AI is baked right into Android and Search. It's helping people summarize web pages, brainstorm ideas, translate languages, all in real time. They're not talking about AI as a future thing, they're doing it now. Even the smaller players, startups, indie devs, are pushing out insane tools. From voice clones to AI video editors to digital assistants that book your meetings and call your dentist for you. Like seriously, the pace is wild. So against all that, Apple's been oddly quiet. For a company that's usually front and center when the future's being shaped, their absence has been loud. And now, just as they start to talk about something called Apple Intelligence, people are asking, is it too little too late? Because in a world that's moving this fast, waiting too long doesn't make you mysterious, it makes you irrelevant. So here's where it gets really wild. According to a brand new report from CNET, a massive 73% of iPhone users say Apple's new AI features don't really bring much value to their phones. 73%. That's nearly 3 out of 4 people saying, yeah, we're good without it. And if you think that's just Apple users being picky, guess again. Over on the Android side, it's even worse. Around 87% of Samsung users feel the same way. So this isn't just a brand thing, it's a vibe thing. Now let's talk about what people actually care about when it comes to upgrading their phones. And spoiler alert, it's not AI. Most folks say what really matters is better battery life. That's the number one thing. Not some neural network that tries to finish your sentences, just a phone that actually lasts all day. Next up, more storage. Because yeah, we're all drowning in photos, apps, and video clips we're emotionally attached to but we'll never watch again. And right behind that, a better camera. Something that makes your food pics pop and your night shots look like they weren't taken with a toaster. But AI? AI came in way down the list. Only about 18% of people said it was the reason they'd even consider upgrading. And here's the kicker. Almost half the people surveyed said they wouldn't pay even a penny extra for AI features. Not a cent. That's a problem for any tech company banking on AI as the next premium upsell. Oh, and there's more. About a third of the people said they're actually worried about privacy when it comes to AI, which is a huge red flag, because if there's one brand that made privacy its whole identity, it's Apple. Yet even with Apple's track record, people are still hesitant to trust AI wrapped in an Apple logo. So it's not just that users aren't excited, it's that they're uninterested, unwilling to pay, and in some cases, actively concerned. And when you're Apple, the company that sells not just tech but trust, that's a massive disconnect. So why does all of this even matter? I mean, okay, so people aren't exactly jumping up and down over AI in their iPhones. Big deal, right? Well, actually, yeah, it is a big deal. Because Apple's entire empire is built on two things: trust and the idea that they know what's next before we do. People trust Apple to make tech that just works, that feels good to use, that's secure, that respects your privacy. It's not about being the first, it's about being the best. And for the longest time, that belief has been enough to make Apple the default choice for millions. We didn't need to question whether their next big thing was worth it, we knew it would be. But now, for the first time in a long time, people are questioning whether Apple really knows what we want. Because with AI, the excitement just isn't there. And even worse, the trust is wobbling. We've been told for years that Apple is a privacy-first company, the one that wouldn't sell our data or spy on us like other tech giants. But now, people are starting to say, wait, how do I know what this AI feature is doing in the background? Who sees that? So now we're in this weird space where Apple's trying to lead us into a new era, and a lot of people are just crossing their arms and saying, no thanks. And if Apple can't fix that, it's not just about AI, it's about the entire narrative they've built for decades starting to crack. But let's not count them out yet. Because if there's one thing Apple knows how to do, it's wait until the moment is right, and then completely redefine the game. This isn't new. Apple wasn't the first with the MP3 player. The iPod just did it better. They weren't the first smartphone either, but the iPhone, that changed everything. Same with wireless earbuds, the Apple Watch, tablets, heck, even the Vision Pro. Say what you will, but it's shaping conversations around spatial computing like no other headset has. That's the Apple playbook. So what if they're doing the same thing with AI? Imagine an iPhone where you don't even see the AI. It's just quietly making your life easier. Your reminders are smarter, your calendar reschedules based on weather, your emails write themselves in your tone, your photos sort themselves before you even open the gallery. That's the version of AI people would use. The invisible kind. The kind that feels like magic, not math. And if Apple can deliver that, if it shows the world not just what AI is, but what it feels like when it's truly helpful, then it doesn't matter that they showed up late, because they'll still be the ones setting the standard. The real danger isn't that Apple doesn't build great AI, it's that users stop believing Apple is building the future. Because if that narrative breaks, so does the loyalty, so does the brand magic, and suddenly, Apple's just another phone maker. And we've seen what happens to phone makers who lose momentum. Remember BlackBerry? Remember Nokia? They didn't disappear because they lacked talent or resources, they disappeared because they misunderstood what the user wanted next. And right now, users are telling Apple exactly that. Apple is standing at a critical junction. If it continues to position AI as just another feature, buried in settings, barely explained, then adoption will lag and competitors will define the AI narrative. But if Apple reframes AI as something fundamental to a better, more secure, more intuitive iPhone experience, and shows, not tells, how it enhances real life, then it has a shot at rewriting the rules again. But that clock is ticking, because tech doesn't wait for anyone, not even Apple. 73% of users are saying no thanks to Apple's AI. But what if that's just the start of a bigger story? One where the world's most beloved tech brand has to convince its biggest fans to believe in the future again. What do you think? Is AI on your phone something you want? Would you pay for it? Do you trust Apple to handle it better than Google or Microsoft? Drop your thoughts in the comments below. I'll be replying to everyone, and I really want to hear what you think. If this video helped you see the future a little clear, give it a like. And if you want to be the first to see the next big shifts in tech, hit subscribe.